Hello everyone, welcome to this session on cybersecurity. Today we are going to look at a concept called chain of custody. So I have already discussed about chain of custody in one of the previous sessions. Anyway, we are going to look at that again. So as you already know, there are different steps in the digital forensics lifecycle, identification of the evidence, identification of the evidence, search and seizure of the evidence. After that, there is preservation of the evidence, and then examination, followed by analysis, and finally reporting. Okay, so throughout all these steps, different things are going to happen, and whenever a particular thing will happen, for example, collecting the evidence, the person has to document whatever he is collecting and what are the different what is the context or what is the different environmental conditions under which the evidence is collected. Okay, so all those things are going to be written in a document, and that document is called chain of custody. Okay, so you can see here, a chain of custody is the process of validating how evidences have been gathered, tracked, and protected on the way of way to the court of law. Okay, so without chain of custody, whatever evidence the forensic people gathers, it is worthless. Okay, so your chain of custody helps to defend your evidence, right? So actually, what is chain of custody is, it's a chronological written record that is from past to present, what are the different events happened, and what the individuals taking care of different events. Okay, and all those things are written in a document. That document is called chain of custody. Okay, so it contains all the events from the initial collection or acquisition to its final disposition at the court. Okay, so it begins when the evidence is collected, and it is carried out until this chain is disposed of. Okay, so the chain of custody assumes continuous accountability. Okay, so that is about chain of custody. We are also going to look at another concept called network forensics. So almost all of the cyber crimes, or majority of the cyber crimes, are committed using or through a network. Okay, so and nowadays all the networks are wireless networks. Of course, there are wired networks, but most of the networks are wireless networks, and most of those wireless networks which we use the technology Wi-Fi are generally unprotected. Okay, and when I say unprotected, I mean the networks which are available at public places like railway stations, airports, malls, lodges, etc. Those are generally unprotected. So whenever you are using Wi-Fi in the public places, never enter any sensitive information like username and password. Otherwise, if you have to enter the sensitive information, please use a VPN. Okay, right. So wireless forensics, it's a part of network forensics, which in turn is a part of computer forensics. So what is wireless forensics or network forensics means? It's the methodology and tools required to collect, analyze the network traffic, which can be presented as varied digital evidence at the court of law. Okay, so basically what are the principles or process and tools that you are using to gather evidence in a network, that is called wireless forensics. And generally the evidence that is collected in the network forensics or wireless forensics involves plain data, okay, textual data, or it can be VoIP information, that is voice over IP. Okay, voice calls which are made through internet. And what does wireless forensics involve is that is the process which is followed in wireless forensics is these are the things. So first one is capturing all the data moving over the Wi-Fi network by using tools like Wireshark, etc., and analyzing network events to uncover any anomalies, okay, and discovering source of security attacks, who is performing the cyber crime like that, and finally investigating breaches on computers and wireless networks. So these are all the things that happens in wireless forensics, and that's it about network forensics. Thank you.